Do subscribe to IKIDA channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Nelson and Stahl's experiment basically laid a very firm theory. They said that DNA was semi-conservative. When I say semi-conservative, semi means half, and when I say conservative, it means of the previous part. What Nelson and Stahl basically said about their experiment, or after the experiment was done by, is whenever DNA replication takes place, the new strand that is formed, or you can say the new progeny that is formed, will have one strand which is from the old parent strand and one new strand. So every DNA strand that was formed in Nelson and Stahl's experiment would conclude one parental strand and one new strand. This was semi-conservative. Now, how they did that experiment? What Nelson and Stahl did is they took two isotopes of N15 and N14, out of which N15 was the heavier isotopes and N14 was the lighter isotopes. And they can, when you did density gradient centrifugation with the help of cesium chloride, the heavier isotope, due to its heavy weight, would settle down, whereas the lighter isotope, due to its light weight, would come up in the solution of cesium chloride. He took a petri plate containing media, nutrient broth, all the serums, all the necessary requirements, and he inoculated E. coli species in that media. Along with that media and E. coli species, he added both the heavy as well as the light isotopes. He added the N15 as well as the N14 isotopes, and he allowed the E. coli species to utilize the food source and grow and observe the results. If Nelson and Stahl's were trying to prove that DNA was semi-conservative, then at the end of their experiment, both the DNA strands, the progeny or the hybrid that is formed, one should contain the lighter isotopes and one should contain the heavier isotopes. That would be fair and quick to say that DNA was semi-conservative. During Nelson and Stahl's experiment, what they tried to prove is that DNA was semi-conservative. Now, this experiment provided the conclusive proof that DNA was semi-conservative. He used an N15 heavy isotope of nitrogen and N14 light isotope of nitrogen and cultured it with E. coli species in a media along with these isotopes and did successive studies for few generations. The E. coli species with N15 DNA isotope were transported or were kept in ordinary N14 containing DNA replication isotope species. And what he observed was that Now, the DNA samples after successive introspection or after successing breeding E. coli in different N14 and N15 isotope media for successive generations, once it was done, then Nelson and Stahls, what they did was they took the DNA samples and then the samples were centrifuged to observe the intermediate densities, that which sample was transferred in which manner. A heavy DNA with N15 in both the strands would have to settle down or sink down in the solution of cesium chloride, whereas the light N14 would rise up higher level. Students, this was the basis on which Nelson and Stahl's experiment was done. Now what he did was, he took the light DNA that was N14, and along with that DNA, he also took another DNA, or you can say two isotopes. One was N15 and another was N14. And once the N14 and N15 DNA, or you can say isotopes, were included in E. coli medium, and E. coli medium would take that DNA, or you can say that isotopes, alternatively, and what we observed was you got an hybrid DNA. Now this hybrid DNA has both the strand. The one strand was made up of N14, whereas another strand was made up of N15, whereas the parental strands that were present initially had only N14 and N15. So as you observed, hybrid DNA had both N15 and N14. And once the E. coli produced its progeny or daughter cells, this hybrid DNA could be observed in Nelson and Stahl's experiment. So students, if I have to summate this or I have to sum up this in one sentence, I could say this, that Nelson and Stahl's experiment proved that DNA was semi-conservative. One strand of DNA had one pair, or you can say one part that is old parental part and one part which is the newly formed part. I hope you all are clear about this Nelson and Stahl's experiment. Thank you.